Good morning.
Good morning.
Much is demanded of a disciple of Jesus Christ, as we will find out in today's gospel reading. However, the rewards are great, and hope of rejoicing in that number and marching in with all the saints in glory is indeed the invitation of the baptized and those claimed for Christ by the sign of the cross. We ask that you continue safety and concern towards others by wearing masks during Mass and when you come forward to receive Holy Communion. Those coming forward to receive the Holy Eucharist on the hand only, and please hold your hand flat. Also, please do not wear gloves to receive the host. Parents, we ask for you to be vigilant in caring for your children, mindful of the transmission of germs and viruses. Also, please do not leave tissues after you in the pews. Please do not use alcohol wipes to clean the pews. It strips the finish. The church is sprayed after Mass with a sanitizer that is safe. In observation of the July 4th holiday, the church office will be closed on Friday. On behalf of Father Vincent, deacons, and staff, I take this time to wish you a happy 4th of July. So you can begin to prepare your calendar for the Stan Fortuna of the Franciscan Friars of Renewal will be here for the St. Anne Novena. Welcome to this place of worship, a place where the cross stands as witness and where we claim the faith of Jesus Christ. Welcome to any visitors joining us today, and may St. Anne pray for us and Mary, the Mother of God, intercede for us.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Sisters and brothers, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves for the sacred mysteries.
Lord, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, when we pray that we may not be wrapped in darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth, to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second book of Kings. One day, Elisha came to Shunem, where there was a woman of influence who urged him to dine with her. Afterward, whenever he passed by, he used to stop there to dine. So she said to her husband, "I know that Elisha is a holy man of God. Since he visits us often, let us arrange a little room on the roof and furnish it for him with a bed, table, chair, and lamp, so that when he comes to us, he can stay there." Sometime later, Elisha arrived and stayed in the room overnight. Later, Elisha asked, "Can something be done for her?" His servant Gehazi answered, "Yes. She has no son, and her husband is getting on in years." Elisha said, "Call her." When the woman had been called and stood at the door, Elisha promised, "This time next year, you will be fondling a baby son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm. Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
The promises of the Lord I will sing forever. Through all generations, my mouth shall proclaim your faithfulness. For you have said, "My kindness is established forever." In heaven, you have confirmed your faithfulness.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
Bless the people who know the joyful shout. In the light of your countenance, O Lord, they walk. At your name, they rejoice all day. And through your justice, they are exalted.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
You are the splendor of their strength, and by your favor, our horn is exalted. For to the Lord belongs our shield, and to the Holy One of Israel, our King.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ raised from the dead dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his apostles, "Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me, and whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me, and whoever does not take up his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. Whoever finds his life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Whoever receives you receives me, and whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. Whoever receives a prophet because he is a prophet will receive a prophet's reward, and whoever receives a righteous man because he is a righteous man will receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives only a cup of cold water to one of these little ones to drink, because the little one is a disciple, amen, I say to you, he will surely not lose his reward." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord
Jesus. As disciples of Jesus Christ, we all know that the most fundamental principle of our Christian life is to love God above all things and to love our neighbor as ourselves. In the Gospel today, Jesus tells us how to fulfill this twofold commandment of loving God and loving our neighbor. The first part of the commandment is to love God. To love God is to put him first above all things, even before those who we love the most, like our father or mother, or spouse or children. To say I love God is always easy, but to do it is another story. We often find some excuses not to do it. We excuse ourselves from coming to Jesus. The excuses often go like this: I have a family party, or my child has a soccer game on this Sunday, or there is an LSU game today, so sorry, Jesus. Loving God means that we cannot let anything or anyone stand between you and God. In a family, do not stand between your children and God, and do not let your children stand between you and God. In our society, it is tempted to think that to love children is to put them above all things, even before God. It is not. Truly to love our children is to bring them and introduce them to Christ. Because in a Christian family, each member is to help one another to grow in holiness. Each member is to help one another to go to heaven. We should never draw others away to Christ, but we must bring our loved ones to Christ. The second part of the commandment is to love our neighbor as ourselves. It is a natural step after the commandment of loving God. When we truly love God, we will naturally love one another. St. John teaches us that if anyone says, "I love God," but hates his brother, he is a liar. For whoever does not love a brother whom he has seen cannot love God whom he has not seen. So sisters and brothers, to love someone is to will and to do the good of the other. For us Christians, in the end, what matters is not what we possess, but what we have done for others. What truly matters in the end is not what we have, but what we have given away. What we do out of love for others will never go unnoticed. Even a small act like giving a cold cup of water to the little one. A good example comes from the first reading today. The Shunammite woman and her husband welcomed the prophet Elisha, the man of God, into their home. And God rewarded this childless couple greatly, more than they ever imagined. He gave them a baby son. So that's the lesson for us, sisters and brothers. What we will be rewarded in heaven will be much greater than what we have given away to others. Love God above all things, and love our neighbor as ourselves. It is always easy to say, but difficult to do. Because love always requires sacrifices. Love without sacrifices is not true love. Following Jesus always comes with a cost, and for some people, it may cost them their own lives. But in the end, what we give away will be nothing compared to the reward awaiting for us in heaven. Because remember that an act of love, no matter how little it is, will never go unnoticed. Even it is just a small cup of water.
Together, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is the Lord glorified, whom I have spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Sisters and brothers, the good news of God's word fills as we recall what he has done for us. With a spirit of confidence, let us pray to Jesus in whose ministry and mission we share.
For Pope Francis, Archbishop Gregory Amon, and clergy everywhere, and for the people they have been called to serve in Christ's name, we pray especially for our desire to be hospitable in every way towards others. As we seek to make flesh the desire and ministry of Jesus Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For peace among nations and for the grace to make right decisions in life, may those who come to this land seeking refuge and relief find among Christ's disciples a respectful and warm welcome. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who may be considering a vocation to the priesthood and religious life, we pray especially for our seminarians and newly ordained priests getting ready to start the mission of Jesus Christ in their first assignment. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the safety of all those traveling over the July 4th holiday, and that through the intercession of Our Lady of Prompt Succor, the Lord may protect us and deliver us from all harm during the hurricane season. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our departed brothers and sisters, claimed for Christ in baptism by the sign of the cross, we pray especially for Mary Alfano and Gertrude McDermott, who died recently. May they now enjoy the reward Jesus promised to be virtuous. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the intentions of this Mass, the needs of the people who come here to the shrine in prayer, and the prayers we hold in our hearts united in the Holy Spirit with St. Anne, and all the saints who stand before the throne of the Lamb, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Together we pray our family prayer.
Loving and faithful God, through the years of people of our archdiocese, have appreciated the prayers and love of Our Lady of Prompt Succor in times of war, disaster, epidemic, and illness. We come to you, Father, with Mary, our mother, and ask you to help us in battle of today against violence, murder, and racism. We implore you to give us your wisdom, that we may build a community founded on the values of Jesus, which gives respect to life and dignity of all people. Bless parents that they may form their children in faith. Bless and protect our youth that they may be peacemakers of our time. Give consolation to those who have lost loved ones around us. Hear our prayer and give us the perseverance to be a voice for life and human dignity in our community. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Our Lady of Prompt Succor, hasten to help us. Mother Mary Magdalene, pray for us that we may be a holy family.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who graciously accomplish the effects of your mysteries, when we pray that the gifts by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration, we acclaim,
Holy, 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 Holy Lord,
so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, save us, Savior of the world,
for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Gregory our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into a light of your face. Have mercy on us, all we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. To him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, power, and glory
will stand forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God,
behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Thank you. us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bow to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever. To Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Glorify.